entirely flat, you'll see what the wall looks like, and it's pretty impressive. If the cameras can look down here. And these are the real people. These are the workers that put up the wall, by the way. All of these guys, they don't do as much of that, but these guys do a great job, and we appreciate them. These are the ones that are here. Each one of these is considered a panel. When they said, how many panels are you going to put in?
Well, 44,000 are in right now.
44,000 are already in. Each one of these, if you look, they're together. So each one of these, I think they have, so they would have, yeah, like eight bollards. And each one of, so I guess it's mostly an eight bollard. We also have some very sophisticated openings when you have to get the Border Patrol through or various people through to the other side. We have some really beautiful openings that work, I hear, really well. I hear we finally figured that one out, right? That was not an easy thing to figure out because of the weight. The weight is tremendously heavy. But if you look down here, you'll see what the wall looks like. And the beautiful thing is that people are seeing that. We're not going to do, in another week, I understand, no more catch and release. We're not allowing people into the country at all anymore. Nobody's coming in unless they're coming in legally. They're coming in through a process. We have it covered between 27,000 Mexican soldiers, and really now the wall is starting to kick in very big. San Diego was just, they were just thanking me for the wall we built in San Diego. It's like, they said it's the difference of day and night. They actually said it's 100%. The only thing is, we have to now expand it out. The only way they get through is to walk many, many miles in the opposite direction, one way or the other, and go around it. But going over it is impossible, is virtually impossible. But they were very, very happy with what we've done. So. The days, and I tell you this very strongly, no more people can come in. We wanted Congress to help us. It would have made life very easy, and we still want them to get rid of loopholes, but we've done it a different way. We've done it with the help of Mexico. We've done it with the help of Border Patrol, and we've done it with the help of Kevin and all of you great people and Mark. We've done it a different way. We still want them to do it because it would be a little bit easier, but Congress wouldn't do it. When I say Congress, the Democrats just wouldn't do it. So now we have a world-class security system at the border, including the highest technology. I would think that there's no place like this anywhere. There's no place has anything like this or even close to it. Now, other places have guards, and unfortunately, they have machine guns, and they have electrified fences. You touch them, you get electrocuted. We don't do that. We don't do that. But this is something that is equally difficult to get across.
Can you explain what was here before? Was there fencing here?
We had a very low fencing here. In fact, you were here before, I think. We had a very low fencing. It was a like a sheet metal. And people would knock it over, like, just routinely. And we ripped it out. We have a lot of areas where we had that and even less than that. And then we have areas where we had nothing. We had some areas where we just had a pipe along the ground, and that sort of stopped cars or trucks, but that knocked that out pretty quickly. So those are areas, but in this case, we had, you saw it, it was sheetrock, it was like sheet metal, a very thin, used to build runways as just a form to build runways. And they had a lot of it left over years ago, and they put it up, but it would be knocked down on a daily basis. Tell them about that.
Mr. President, this is the same area we had the prototype built. The President was here 18 months ago. We now have 24 miles of new primary and secondary wall in this sector. The difference that makes for us operationally is instead of 300 to 500 people crossing a day, we're now seeing 30 to 50. And combined with our partnership with Mexico, where people aren't being released into the U.S., the traffic in the sector has dropped dramatically. That's how your strategy is coming into play.
And the only way you get to 50 is they walk around the areas like this that aren't, you know, we haven't sealed this up yet. We'll be sealing this up very shortly. Or in part of this, we have a gate. But the only way you get to 50, nobody's going over the wall, but where we are still building it, that's where they get to 50. We think it's going to be close to 100% in the end. I don't think anybody's, I guess, maybe one of the greatest pole vaulters in history can get over